Like many of us, for me, summer begins with the first dip in a cool Michigan lake. I mean, after all, when you live in Michigan, you don't live more than 6 miles away from a body of water. So I grew up exploring the creeks and rivers, ponds and lakes that surround us here in the Great Lakes State. My friends and I used to have lake days where we'd go spend an afternoon at a nearby lake and we would picnic and swim together. And sometimes it feels like it's always been this way. So let's just imagine for a second.
The year is 1916. Like many of us, you are spending a beautiful day on Belle Isle. You take a rowboat out in the lagoon. You go to the aquarium to cool off. You end up strolling along the river looking over to Canada when all of a sudden a roar races across the water. It sounds like one of those automobiles your family just purchased, but it's going much faster. You look out on the water to see a speedboat practically flying. You might not know it yet, but this boat is the beginning of a change in how Detroiters and the rest of the world have fun on the water. The boat is the Miss Detroit, and the man who drove it is the subject of this episode of Detroit History Heroes.
Welcome to Detroit History Heroes, a show where we explore the stories of some fantastic Detroiters. My name is Kayla, and I work for the Detroit Historical Society. And today, we're going to talk about Gar Wood, the engineer and inventor who revolutionized America's roadways and waterways. Garfield Arthur Wood was born in 1880 in Mapleton, Iowa, which was a small farming community then known as East Mapleton. He was named after the U.S. President and Vice President from the year he was born. James A. Garfield, who was the president, our 20th president at the time, and Chester Allen Arthur, his VP, who became the 21st president later. That'd be like if I was named Bush Quail, which doesn't seem like much of a name. Just like Fanny Richards, we don't know a lot about Gar Wood's childhood, but we do know one thing for certain. He was born with a love of water in his veins. His father was a ferry boat captain on Lake Osakis, Minnesota. When Gar was 12, he got his first job ferrying around fishing tourists. At age 17, he began piloting his own boat, an inspection boat for a local railroad company. At that young age, he invented the first downdraft carburetor to help his boat go faster. As you might have already noticed, we spent a lot of time talking this episode about how we use our waterways, both for fun and for business. There was once a time you couldn't even get around this area without having to use our waterways. So for more, let's go to our flash footnotes.
Tired of getting lost in the woods while exploring New France? Looking for a way to trade furs without having to walk through mosquito-infested swampland? Try the Great Lakes Waterway. For thousands of years, this has been New France's best-kept secret. This revolutionary superhighway can get you anywhere. Fort Miami? No problem. The trading post out on Le Bay une Pune? Absolutely. Fort Pontchartrain de Detroit? Easy as un, deux, trois. Just listen to this satisfied customer.
Mais oui, I am a voyageur. I came here to New France to find the Le Castor so I could sell it. And when I came here, everybody warned me. They say the forests are so dense you cannot see anything and it is very difficult to travel around. But I found if I take La Grande Lorse, I can get around very easily. I have no problems anymore. This or this would recommend.
As you can see, the waterways of Michigan have always been a part of our lives and have helped us become the state we know and love today. Now back to Gar Wood.
Gar Wood attended the Armor Institute of Technology in Chicago and became a marine engine mechanic. He married his wife Merlin around this time and the two moved to St. Paul, Minnesota. In 1911, at age 31, he took a risk and invested his life savings in a new invention. Not in boating technology, but in the ways other industries use trucks. He invented the hydraulic lift to raise the bed of trucks so that it could be used for coal mining. In other words, Gar Wood invented the dump truck.
This helped establish Gar Wood as a go-to innovator and inventor, and the money, as they say, kept rolling in. Or at least that's what Andrew Lloyd Webber says in Evita. Gar Wood spent the rest of his life patenting new inventions and innovations that helped change the way we use cars and trucks and boats. Some of his designs even helped the Allies win World War II. Now successful and bringing along his, count them, 8 brothers into his business venture, Wood decided to establish his own company.
So where's a young industrialist with a knack for automotive and marine engineering to go to make a lot of money? Detroit. Garwood established his first company, Wood Hoist Company, in Detroit, and then later changed the company name to Garwood Industries. He worked on hydraulic truck beds, truck bodies, and a little something called the Garwood Load Packer. That's right, Garwood invented the modern garbage truck.
It was in Detroit that Gar was able to rekindle his love of boating and invest his time, money, and energy into it. One boat in particular caught Gar's eye, a beautiful hydroplane called Miss Detroit.
According to the New York Times article from 1915 about Miss Detroit, it was designed by Chris Smith and owned by Detroit Powerboat Association and won that year's Gold Cup. This win helped establish Detroit as a seat of hydroplane racing.
Gar purchased Miss Detroit in 1916 and became fascinated by Chris Smith's designs. Together, the two of them designed several boats, all named Miss Detroit. Between 1917 and 1921, with Gar driving and Chris designing, the two won 5 Gold Cups in a row. Around this time, Gar also started racing internationally with his other series of boats, the Miss Americas. Gar won a total of 9 Harmsworth trophies throughout his career. A Harmsworth trophy was a trophy that was awarded to hydroplane racing on an international scale.
Gar's Miss America hydroplanes were the fastest boats around. This was due to the addition of the Liberty V12 engines that were originally designed for airplanes. This completely changed the speed of his boats, so much so that Gar Wood broke the water speed record 5 times. When Miss Detroit won the Gold Cup in 1915, Gar was only driving 45 miles per hour. Miss America 1 reached 75 miles per hour. By the time Gar was racing Miss America 10, he was racing up to 125 miles per hour. One time he was racing the Miss America 9 while there was a gas tank crack, risking explosion. He was disqualified for going too fast in that race. He raced a train in 1912 from Miami to New York City and beat the train in his Gar 2 boat. Fun fact, Gar always raced with 2 teddy bears, Teddy and Brune. They were his good luck charms.
Garwood Industries continued to make boats until 1947. Even into his 80s, Garwood continued to innovate and revolutionize both the auto industry and the boating industry. Enthusiasts in both fields consider his name synonymous with ideas of quality products and amazing feats. When he passed, the Detroit News said this of him: if he announced that he was going to take off for the moon, his faithful following would have believed him. To the public, he was Tom Swift, Jules Verne, Frank Merriwell, and even a little Horatio Alger thrown in. Garwood helped put Detroit on the map for sportsmanship, invention, and innovation. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe to the Detroit Historical Society channel for more stories about your favorite Detroiters. Let us know which Detroit history hero you want to learn about in the comments down below. If you want to learn more about Garwood or other Detroit stories, visit our website at DetroitHistorical.org. Hang out with us on Facebook at Detroit Historical Society. You can follow us on Twitter at DHS Detroit and on Instagram at Detroit Historical. My name is Kayla, and this has been Detroit History Heroes. See you next time!